One popular question that I always get asked is, Dr. Lau, can I become a data scientist or data analyst even if I'm not good with maths or statistics? Short answer, yes, you can. I'm not good at maths either. I become a data scientist with logics and algorithms. Then I pick up mathematics and statistics during my career. So let's find out the role of maths and statistics in data science. Mathematics is called the universal language of science, where scientists use a standardized vocabulary, grammar, and syntax to communicate with each other so that everybody can understand each other, even if you are from a different country, different culture background, and speak different languages. Most people didn't learn mathematics well during their high school because the way mathematics is taught. We're always told to memorize formulas, equations like theorem Pythagoras, normal distributions. But as a student and also as an applied science person myself, what I don't get is, how is this going to change my life? Or is there any real world applications out of this? Even if you're not good at mathematics right now, you can still begin data science and build up your mathematics knowledge. And then start to uncover the joy of using these formulas and equations to solve real world problems. And this is the best way to learn. For example, you can use theorem Pythagoras, the one that I mentioned earlier, and to compare the similarity of two text documents, and then group these documents together and find out the keywords and common topics. Or you can simply calculate the frequency of words in your email, and then using some probability theories to predict whether an incoming email is a spam or not. What I notice is that many people are trying too hard and forcing themselves to learn maths and stats before breaking into data science. Well, you don't have to do that. At the end of the day, learning the minimum amount of mathematics and statistics is sufficient. As long as you know how to pick the right models for different data types, and that's good enough for you to kickstart your data science career. Now, which parts of the maths and statistics are the one that you hate the most and the one that you like the most? Let me know in the comment section, and I'll see you in the next video.